Good morning, friends. Happy Tuesday. Happy day one of our challenge. I'm so excited for this challenge. I have been working on it and changing things up when I feel led to, and I just have a lot of information to bring you guys this week. And so I hope you're ready. I have my notes so that I don't miss anything because I tend to get very excited about these topics and just talk a lot. So we have a lot of new faces that joined this week. So I just want to say hello to everyone who recently joined the group. I'm so happy you're here. If you signed up for the challenge late last night, I approved everyone right before hopping on, but you might have missed the email with the worksheet, but fear not. Another email is coming out today, recapping this video in written form along with the day one worksheet and then day two's worksheet for tomorrow. So look out for your email for that coming later today. And I'm just really, really excited. I wanted to make this like accessible for different learning types. So this is video form. You're going to get the written email later. And then you can also write out your thoughts after the teaching so that you can kind of learn in different ways. I know different people learn in different ways. So I just wanted to make it accessible to everyone. So I am so, so, so excited about this topic. This is the topic. This is the mindset shift, I will say, that really transformed my nutrition philosophy. If you're new here, I'm a dietitian. I have a master's in public health nutrition. I went through a lot of school, a lot of knowledge in my head, but I had such a hard time applying that knowledge to my day-to-day life in a way that was, oh, I'm bleeding. That's weird. In a way that's sustainable and in a way that really transformed my life. I knew a lot about nutrition. I was book smart with nutrition, but my mindset was in the gutter because I went through years of at first anorexia and then binge eating. And this is since I was 14 years old. And it seeped into my college years, my grad school years, dating my then boyfriend, now husband, and even into our marriage and even into motherhood. Because eating issues, they ebb and flow. They come and go, but the goal is to just be consistent. The goal is to never give up, because when you never give up, you're never off track. And that's what I always tell my one-on-one clients. You're never off track with this way of this lifestyle, this nourishment-free lifestyle that I've created. Because there's no messing up. You just continue on. And that's actually one of the mindset shifts later this week. But today we're going to talk about the mindset shift that I kind of realized on December 1st, 2015. I still remember the date because I had to call off work that day because I had binged so bad the night before. I was nauseous. I had a headache. I felt like I was going to throw up. And I just felt honestly like crap. I felt miserable. I felt like this was never going to change. I was a newlywed. We were like 7 or 8 months married, and it was still, binging was still a part of my life, emotional eating. I just felt like I couldn't get this under control, and it was taking over my life to the point where I had to call off of work. And it was depressing. It was very depressing. And I wanted to figure out a way that I could live out the principles that I learned in school as a dietitian without it being an obsessive perfectionist mentality. I am a perfectionist. I want to do things very, very well. And with perfectionism, a lot of times is self-sabotage, because you're almost punishing yourself for not being perfect by sabotaging your efforts. And so this can play out in a lot of different ways, but a lot of perfectionists actually have eating issues, eating disorders, disordered eating patterns, what have you. So I remember that morning sitting on the floor of our little 500 square foot apartment and throwing everything, every diet I'd ever tried out the window, because what I went to fix my eating issues were diets. It went to MyFitnessPal, Weight Watchers, calorie counting in general. And then, you know, I tried Whole30s, which messed me up even more. And again, these might work for you. That's the beauty of Nourished and Free, is you have to find what works for you. I have clients who do great on keto, intermittent fasting. I have a vegan client. I have a vegetarian client. It's bio-individual, because what's different for you and your mindset. And so what I tried did not work for me. Whole30 made my binging 100 times worse. You know, intermittent fasting, I wake up starving. I'm hungry now and at 6 a.m. Like, intermittent fasting would never work for me. So you have to know yourself. And the key here is that I had to change the way I had thought about health. I thought that to be healthy, I had to be perfect. I thought that to be, you know, the weight I wanted to be, or the energy that I wanted to have, or, you know, the way I wanted to show up for my marriage or my family, was that I had to be perfect. And it was just false. It wasn't true. So I decided to throw everything out the window. And I focused on, instead of the gray areas of nutrition, which is meat good or bad? Does coffee cause cancer or does it actually help Alzheimer's? Is sugar bad for you, or is it just sugar? It doesn't harm you. Are whole grains good for you, or are they toxic because of the phytates and the lectins and blah, blah, blah? I decided to throw all the gray areas of nutrition out the window and focus on what I actually knew to be true, which is the power of vegetables and whole foods. They'll never write a research paper being like, vegetables cause heart disease and cancer. Like, no, they'll never write that in research, right? So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna throw out all the gray areas. And if I focus on making my diet, which all diet means is what you eat in a typical day. I'm not talking about like restrictive diets. I'm talking about what you eat in a typical day. If I just focus on getting those vegetables in, getting those whole foods in as much as possible, then whether I had beans on my salad or meat on my salad wouldn't matter. Whether I had a cookie or a banana wouldn't matter, because the foundation of my day, of my nutrition, was going to be these whole healthy foods that were known to be good for us, that were never going to be researched to find out that they're actually like harmful for our health, right? So I focus on adding these foods to my day. I remember I went to Sprouts. I got like every vegetable they had at Sprouts. I got spelt flour. I got whole grain flour. I got some protein. I got eggs. I focus on whole, real foods. That was gonna be my focus. And I started calling this addition nutrition. So instead of focusing on no grains, no beans, no dairy, no sugar, no meat, no blah, 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 I was like, forget the no's. I want the yeses. I wanna add as much healthy food to my life as possible. And so if we were at church and we ordered pizza, I was gonna order a salad too. If I had a burger and fries, I was gonna make sure to snack on some veggies and dip before, you know, the barbecue. Whatever it was, I wanted to add vegetables to my plate, to my meals, to my snacks, to my breakfast smoothie. I tried to add vegetables in as much as possible, and I felt amazing. I remember telling my husband back then, I feel like Wonder Woman, because I was never feeling scarcity around what I was eating. I actually felt abundance. I was like, okay, what else can I add? What new vegetable can I try this week? What new salad dressing can I add to my like greens? What new greens can I try? There were so many options, you guys, because God created so many foods for us to eat. There are so many God created foods on this earth that what we do is we focus on what we shouldn't have. Don't have the donut, don't have the Cheez-Its, don't have the chips, don't have the brownies. But we're not focused on what to have. I actually have a really good example of this that happened recently with one of my clients last week. She works from home and she struggles with chips at home. And every morning when she wakes up, she says, I'm not gonna have the chips this morning. I'm not gonna have the chips this morning. And by 2 p.m., guess who's had 3 bowls of chips? Yeah. So we decided that last week, instead of waking up and telling herself, I'm not going to have the chips, she's going to say, what am I going to have today? How can I nourish my body today? And if chips are part of the equation, so be it. But what can I have today? What am I going to add to my day today? How will I nourish my body? And I talked to her yesterday and she's like, it's changed so much. I've already had a better week since waking up and telling myself that. There is power in how we speak to ourselves and the mindset shifts we make. So instead of focusing on health as depriving, restrictive, focus on how abundant you'll feel when you'll add these healthy foods to your plate. Healthy lifestyle doesn't have to be restrictive, because the ultimate goal is to feel good, right? You want to have energy. You want to wake up. You want to work out. You want to have energy for your kids. You don't want to feel like 5 p.m. and you're crashing. How is that a punishment? How is that restrictive or depriving to feel the way you want to feel and reach your goals? It's a total mindset shift, right? We all think we have to punish ourselves to be healthy. How about healthy food actually tasting good and enjoying it? I'm telling you, I was so excited to try all these new vegetables. I decided to add so much to my plate. And guess what? If I went to a party and there were like brownies and cakes and pies, I noticed the veggies first. And then if I had a pie, if I had brownie, who cares? I ate it and then I moved on. But my focus wasn't on, oh, I shouldn't have that. Oh my gosh, like you're swatting flies, right? Like, oh my gosh, I can't have the chips and I can't have the sour cream dip and I can't have the brownies. I had those things, but my focus was, let me fill up my plate with that salad. Let me get some carrots and ranch dip before I dig into the chips. Like, I focused on what I wanted to have more of instead of what I wanted to avoid. And that is so powerful when it comes to this mindset shift. And that's what's gonna help you actually enjoy your healthy lifestyle. Because I firmly believe we could all function on different ways of eating that are healthy for us. It all depends on how we're thinking. Your diet could be completely clean, like super clean diet, but if your mindset is in the gutter, that's not healthy for you. So it all depends on where your mindset is. I know people who thrive on keto. They thrive on keto. They could do without bread. They don't care. And then I have people who thrive on a vegan diet. There's a spectrum for everyone. everyone, and you need to find what works for you, which I know is not the very like sexy answer, because everyone wants like, this is what's going to work and this is what you have to do and these are your rules to follow. But when has that ever served you? Have the rules ever helped you get to your goals? Have these lists of no foods ever served you? Has this perfection mentality that you have to avoid these things perfectly ever helped you? No, they never do. They literally never help you, because no one can be perfect. No one. And so I was able to shift my focus, and where we focus on, our energy goes. And I found that my anxiety around food, my obsession with my body and my size and what I looked like, it dwindled, it went away. And since 2015, obviously I've had periods where I've, you know, struggled, postpartum, hormones, emotions, depression, all of those things. But the point is that I have been on this trajectory for almost 6 years because of that first day that I decided to shift my focus to this addition nutrition mindset of, what can I add to my plate? What can I add to my meal plan? You know, if my husband wants like a super creamy chicken casserole, how can I roast some veggies on the side of that? How can I add some cauliflower rice to my regular rice so that I can spice up the veggies a little bit? There's so many ways to kind of inject our meals with so much nutrition that we're feeling abundant in what we're eating, instead of scarcity, instead of like, oh, I have to avoid this, I have to avoid that. And that will be the first step towards having this freeing lifestyle. Nourished and free is about living freely in your healthy lifestyle. You're not feeling restricted. You're not feeling chained down. You're being a good steward of your body by living in this abundantly freeing mentality. I posted this on Instagram yesterday. How about living in this abundance of health versus feeling like you have to restrict and have scarcity and you can't eat any of your favorite foods? That's no way to live long term. And if you're going after a temporary fix, you're going to only yield temporary results. Sorry for the blood, you guys. I have no idea. My hands are so dry. If you're going after a temporary fix, you're only going to yield temporary results and you're going to go right back to where you were. So that is the teaching for today. Addition nutrition. Your foundation is on all the foods you are able to add to your life, add to your plate, and you'll notice that you'll be able to regulate those treats and those sweets so much more moderately and true moderation. You'll actually figure out what moderation means, because everything in moderation is like this like pie in the sky, like vague concept that no one really knows, because moderation is different for everyone, right? And so when you focus on what to add to your day, the healthy foods that you want to add to each and every meal, that will be where true moderation comes in, and you'll actually be able to regulate those treats and those sweets in a much more like portioned way, in a way that will actually still help you reach your goals. You'll still be able to reach your goals. I remember doing a challenge like this a couple years ago, how I lost 20 pounds eating chips and salsa, because I love chips and salsa. And I used to go into Mexican restaurants telling myself, I'm not gonna have chips, I'm not gonna have chips, I'm not gonna have chips. At 4 bowls of chips later, I would feel terrible. And now I say, I have the chips because I love the chips, and the chips are worth it to me. Chips and salsa is like my favorite food in the entire world. So I've been able to lose weight since my heaviest. I've lost about 50 pounds. I've been able to lose weight eating the foods that I love to eat. And that was the most sustainable way for me. Whole30 wasn't sustainable for me. Calorie counting, you know, MyFitnessPal logging, that only hurt my personal mindset. I know it works for other people. For me personally, this is the only way that I've been sustainable. And I've seen this work with countless of my one-on-one clients, where their focus just shifts and they're able to actually enjoy the healthy foods that they're eating, which is very, very important. And so this is the mindset shift for today. Addition nutrition. You can print out your worksheet. You should have gotten it yesterday in your email, but you'll also get it again today. So again, if you signed up really late, you will get this worksheet emailed to you today. Good morning, Cynthia. Good morning, Erin. Good morning, Brandy. So you will get this emailed later today, along with day 2's worksheet as well. But I want you to go through this worksheet, because like I said, teaching is one thing, but activating that knowledge in your life is a totally different thing. We can learn everything we want. We can read all the nutrition books. I love reading nutrition books. I'm rereading one now that I like read on my iBooks, but I had to buy the actual book because I loved it so much. I want to like underline and take notes. I'm a nerd when it comes to absorbing knowledge, but knowledge is nothing if you can't apply it into your life and figure out how it's going to work for you. How are you going to apply what you learn in this challenge and anything else that you've signed up for? How are you going to apply what you learn and actually help it change your life, instead of just being yet another thing that you're going to learn about? And I believe journaling through these questions, doing these worksheets, is one step even closer to making it personalized for you. So there are 4 questions on this worksheet, and it's just talking about a time where you've, you know, you're going to reflect a time where you've cut out foods in your life and how did that make you feel? How do you feel about this addition nutrition shift? And then you're going to actually make your list. I remember making a list that December 1st morning of all of the foods that I could eat instead of focusing on what I couldn't eat. And there were like 50 foods on my list. And I was like, why am I feeling like healthy living has to be this scarcity mentality when there's an abundance of healthy food out there, you guys, that our bodies are made to thrive on. And so you're going to make your own little list of what you're going to start adding to your plate. And then there's just like a reflection area of what else, you know, you kind of got out of this teaching. So if you're watching the replay, comment below with a takeaway that you had from this video. If you're live, you can comment below. If you have any questions throughout these next 3 days, don't hesitate to ask them in the group like feed wall, whatever it's called now. I don't even know. Facebook keeps changing everything. And I will do my best to answer, but I'm so, so, so proud of you guys for taking this step. Mindset work is hard. Most people want the tangible, like tell me what to eat. Tell me what portions I should eat. I get DMs almost daily of like, how many calories should I eat? These are my stats. How many calories? And I'm not answering those questions because that's not what I do. I focus on changing your mindset to change your life. And that is where your health is going to change. And that's where you're going to actually see changes long term versus yet another 2 week, 3 week like gig. And then you're just going to like throw everything out the window and go back to what you've always done, which we don't want to do. And so the next 2 days, I'm so, so excited about. They're really powerful mindset shifts that honestly, it takes my one-on-one clients and 9 months to work through and master. Because in the one-on-one setting, obviously, it's a lot more intimate. It's a high level coaching. We are in each other's lives for like at least 3 months, sometimes longer. But I really, really wanted to get you guys like some of these mindset shifts out there for you guys, because I really, really think they will make a big difference in your life. So make sure to do day one's worksheet. If you signed up late, you will get the email later today with all of you will get an email, the recap from today's video, along with the worksheet from today and the worksheet for tomorrow. So you can print that out ahead of time. But I hope this was helpful for you guys. I hope this kind of changes the way you've seen health and nutrition and kind of gives you hope that you can actually enjoy eating healthy and you can enjoy being healthy and actually make these choices from a place of abundance and freedom instead of scarcity and deprivation. And that's something we're going to talk about a little more tomorrow. So I'll see you guys tomorrow, same time, same place, and hope everyone has a great Tuesday. Bye guys. Good morning, everyone. Wow, my voice is gone. Good morning, everyone. Happy Wednesday and happy day 2 of our challenge. I hope that you've had time to watch yesterday's video and work through the worksheet. I did send out the worksheet again yesterday afternoon, so that should be in your inbox, but I am so excited for day 2. This is a concept that actually takes a lot of trial and error, and it's something that there's like a very important principle with Nourish and Free that I use with my clients, curiosity over judgment. And this one really takes getting curious about yourself, your habits, and how your brain works versus judging your actions and your habits. So it's very, very important. This one will put the power back into your hands. And that's what's really cool about this mindset shift. So this mindset shift is about having the freedom to say yes and the freedom to say no. And that is really what my philosophy of food freedom is about. You have freedom to say yes and there's freedom in no. So if you think about it, a lot of like what people think is like intuitive eating or food freedom or that kind of concept. And it's kind of been twisted now with social media and so many colleagues of mine kind of taking it really, really extreme, is that you say yes to every craving. Freedom is having saying yes to every single thing you want. You crave it, you go get it. You crave it, you go get it. If you think about it, this isn't really how life works, right? Let's say you're walking through Best Buy and you see like a $2,000 TV. Would you just buy it on a whim? Or would you like be like, you know what, actually we're like saving for a house, so I'll have more freedom saying no to the TV so I can say yes to the house. You know, we don't just say yes to every single thing that we crave or comes our way. And so we really need to apply this to our own health and our wellness goals, because if you feel like you just have to say yes to every single craving you have, you're going to constantly feel that struggle of wanting to live a certain healthy lifestyle, but always succumbing to your cravings. And you're going to label yourself as a sugar addict. Well, I'm just an emotional eater. I can't stop stress eating. You're going to give yourself that identity, versus this mindset shift puts the power back into your hands. Like I always say, like you could crave a burger, fries, and milkshake every day, but does that mean you should actually have it every single day? Like, how would that make you feel? You know? So you really have to evaluate what will give you freedom to say yes to and what will give you freedom to say no to. And I like to use the term boundaries and discipline over restriction. There's a big difference. So you put boundaries, like if for your you moms out there, you put boundaries on your kids, right? Like certain shows they can watch. They can't go play out in the street with cars driving. Boundaries on maybe like how many cookies they're going to have before bed so they don't get a tummy ache. You put boundaries around even your own life. And boundaries are, excuse me. Boundaries are very, very healthy because they actually give you freedom within a space that you know that you're going to thrive. And so boundaries are freeing for us. Discipline can actually be freeing for us because we can rely on ourselves instead of motivation. We can rely on our own routines, our boundaries, our disciplined habits instead of just motivation and feeling inspired one day to take action on our goals. And so that it's really, really important to kind of evaluate what helps you thrive, what helps you feel your best, and then placing those boundaries where you can say yes to some things and no to other things in complete freedom, because you know that ultimately that's giving you that freedom that you want. Restriction kind of just cuts things out of shame. So restrictive diets will tell you like carbs are bad, sugar is bad, fruit is bad, meat is bad, beans are bad. So many things. Vegetables are, you know, some people who do strict low carb are afraid of even green vegetables. And so that's restriction based on what's good and what's bad versus boundaries puts it back into your hands. Restriction is more like this external rule you're following. Boundaries are, okay, this is for me. I know that I feel best eating this way, taking care of myself this way, and these are the boundaries that I place for myself. So we need to realize that there's freedom to say yes and freedom to say no. And this can change based on the situation, the context, the day, whatever it is. So there's some nights that my girls want to bake cookies at night or they want to go get ice cream at night, and I have freedom to say yes. I have freedom to say yes, sure, because I trust now that that's not going to lead me to spiral, that that's not going to lead me to binge. And that's actually tomorrow's mindset shift. Tomorrow's one of my favorite ones, so stay tuned for that. But I have freedom to say yes. Some nights though, if I had a really filling dinner or I'm just not feeling good, I'm not feeling the ice cream, I have freedom to say no. And I'm not saying no out of restriction. I'm saying no out of freedom because I'm doing what I know will make me feel better. Again, some nights I say yes, some nights I say no, but it's back into your control. And that's why this concept is very individual. This mindset shift is something that I work really closely with my clients to really evaluate. Would you have freedom to say yes to like the chow mein and the fried rice and the steamed rice, or would you have more freedom to say yes to your favorite one? So I just use Chinese food as the example, but I use chips and salsa as my example for this. So for years, I would avoid the chips, and then end up having the chips, the tortillas, the rice, and the beans, and just feel like crap afterwards. So over the years, again, trial and error, it took a lot of curiosity versus judgment. I realized that my favorite part out of the entire Mexican meal experience was the chips and salsa. So I have freedom now to say yes to the chips and salsa, and I say no to tortillas, rice, and beans like 90% of the time. Sometimes I'll like snag a few bites or use a tortilla, whatever. Most of the time, I have freedom to say yes to the chips and salsa and no to the rice, the beans, the other heavier foods. And I focus on protein and vegetables as my main meal because that gives me the freedom to enjoy the chips and salsa, which is my favorite part of the meal. Do you see where I'm going with this? Like, it gives you the freedom. It puts it back into your hands that you can actually enjoy what's worth it to you without feeling like you're failing anything. I did this a lot when I was doing more low-carb keto last year, pre-COVID, but I would still have chips and salsa, and I would have rice here and there because it was on my terms how I was eating. It wasn't based on this external list of rules that I had to follow. So again, there's freedom to say yes, and there's freedom to say no. And there's freedom in the no because you know you can say yes anytime. You know you can say yes tomorrow if you want the ice cream with your kid, even though you're saying no tonight. There's freedom to say yes, freedom to say no. And I think that that is ultimate freedom because you're functioning in a way that makes you feel your best. So I really want to get this point across today. Food freedom does not just mean saying yes to every single whim, every single craving, every single desire that comes your way, because you're living then enslaved to those cravings, enslaved to those desires. Whereas most cravings, it was a really cool moment I had with a client. I think it was a couple years ago where I said, well, you know, if you crave it, that doesn't mean you have to eat it, right? And she was like, what? Like, it was like mind blowing to her that she didn't have to give into a craving. And I'm like, yeah, like you can crave it and then like not actually take action. It's just a thought. Cravings are just a thought. They're just a thought that passes, like a passing sailing ship through your mind. You can say yes or you can say no, but that's up to you. So let's stop feeling like we're enslaved to these foods. You have the power here. You can say yes without guilt, without shame, because that's freedom for you. Or you can say no without feeling deprived or restricted, because that's freedom for you. So this again is a very, very important concept, and it helps you put the power back into your hands instead of feeling powerless around food. A big part of Nourished and Free, my philosophy, is that empowering women to make these healthy choices. I want to empower you guys to make these healthy choices for yourself instead of constantly going to a 1200 calorie meal plan or, you know, a restrictive diet that hasn't worked for you in the past. I really want to put the power back in your hands and empower you to know yourself enough to say, I'm going to have the chips and salsa, and then I'm going to have, you know, chicken fajitas and veggies for dinner. I'm going to have 2 slices of pizza with a huge salad instead of 5 slices of pizza, because I know that I'll have freedom enjoying 2 slices of pizza. There's freedom in reaching your goals too. This is something that, again, mindset shift. There's freedom in having ice cream every day, right? If you want. There's also freedom in finally reaching your goals and finally losing the weight you want to lose, or in finally stopping binge eating, or in finally stop being obsessed with food. There's freedom in those things. So really evaluate what would be freedom for you. And that's really what the worksheet is about today. I talk about freedom to say yes, freedom to say no in the worksheets, and what habits, even non-food related, do you have more freedom saying yes to and more freedom saying no to? Think about it in a non-food realm and then bring nutrition into it. And then the worksheet goes about what disciplines and habits mean to you and how sometimes there is freedom in the, actually, every time there's freedom in disciplines, I will say. And then write 2 to 3 health and nutrition habits that you'll feel most freedom saying yes to. And then write about habits that you'll feel freedom saying no to. This is really, really important to realize that it's okay to say no. It's okay to give yourself boundaries to thrive in, just like we do with our children, just like we do with our toddlers. Boundaries are healthy. And then my favorite question is, how would you experience more freedom in your life if you reached your goals? Think about the freedom you will have when you do reach your goals, whatever your goals are, whether it's just you want to meal prep more so you guys spend less money eating out. Even if you don't have weight loss goals, you just want to have a healthier relationship with being healthy. You want to feel better. You want to have more energy. You want to play with your kids. You want to wake up early for a workout. How would that give you freedom in your life to reach your goals? Instead of feeling like reaching your goals will take away from your life, how will it actually give you freedom to reach these goals? That's incredibly powerful. And then again, any other light bulb moments from today's teaching is the last question. So you can download this worksheet. I emailed it to you yesterday. I will be emailing it out again later today, along with the recap of today's video. I hope that this was helpful for you guys. Again, this is a mindset shift that takes time and practice, journaling, really getting curious after, you know, let's say you have a chaotic eating experience. After that, it takes getting curious about it instead of just judging and hating yourself and saying, okay, I'm not going to do that next time. And then you'll do it next time. Instead of wondering, why did I do it? Was it emotionally triggered? Was I hungry? What would I want to do next time? Those are much more empowering questions to ask yourself. So anyways, I hope everyone has a great Wednesday. I will be back here tomorrow for our last day. Tomorrow's is one of my favorite mindset shifts, so I can't wait to teach on that one. And I hope you guys have a great Wednesday. Good morning, everyone. Happy Thursday. Happy last day of our challenge. I can't believe it's already day 3. I hope you guys got the worksheet yesterday afternoon and you're ready to dive in to the third mindset shift for Nourished and Free Living. And so this one is one that when the Frozen movies came out and we like listened to the songs over and over and over again. If you don't know, I have a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old girl, and they're both obsessed with Anna and Elsa. And the more I listened to these songs, I was like, oh my gosh, this is like the perfect way to remember what I teach my clients, what I used to call like the move on method. I now called the Frozen phenomenon, because it's so much easier for a lot of us to remember, especially if you've watched the movies and listened to the songs. And so this is one that made such a big difference in my binge eating. So if you're new here, if you're new to my story, I was a binge eater starting at 14 years old, maybe even a little earlier, because it was like 8th grade, I remember, because that's when I went on my very first diet, which always kind of, most of the time, triggers people to start binge eating or emotional eating or just overeating in general, because the diet is so restrictive most of the time. And so I I have a lot of experience with binge eating. I'm a dietitian. I have a master's in public health nutrition. I have a certificate in adult weight management. Again, I've done a lot of learning on this topic, but I actually had to apply it to my life and activate it in my life, which is where the mindset work came in. And so that's why now I marry the two with my nourishing-free method. And so day three is called the frozen phenomenon. And this is one that can change the game for you if you tend to spiral, if you're an all or nothing person, if you have one cookie and then have 12 cookies, this one is for you. So listen up. Print the worksheet, do what you need to do to absorb as much as possible from this teaching, because it's going to be really good. And so most of the women that I coach and that I work with struggle with consistency, right? You'll be good from Monday to Thursday, and then come Friday, there's like donuts in the break room, or it's Friday, so it's Friday, right? And then on the weekend, you tend to spiral, and then you're starting back over every Monday. Comment below if this is your story, because you're not alone, and it happens quite a lot in people who try to live a perfectly healthy lifestyle and that are doing something that just isn't very sustainable. And so consistency is key when it comes to seeing results, but I'm all about imperfect consistency. And I saw my results, I saw my weight loss, and I see my clients lose weight with this concept of imperfect consistency, because it's much more attainable than being perfect 24/7. So let's stop the start over Monday with this particular method. So let's say Friday comes along, your kids want ice cream, you go get ice cream, and you feel such guilt after eating ice cream because it's not on your plan. So then you come home and you eat all the chips in your cupboard, or you polish off the tortilla chips on Saturday afternoon, and then you're like, what the heck, let's order a burger and fries tonight. And then come Sunday, you're like, well, tomorrow's Monday anyway, so let me just keep eating because it's Sunday and I'll start over Monday. What would happen if that Friday night that you decided to go get ice cream with your kids, you just let that go, and then on Saturday, you just went right back to what you normally do? What would happen? Like, I started asking myself that question. All the times that I had let that initial treat spiral me to then binge or overeat or have like this chaotic experience with food for a few days and spiral out of control, I asked myself, what would have happened if I just let the treat be the treat, I let it go, and I did the next right thing? And that's what I like to call the frozen phenomenon. So you let it go and you do the next right thing. Your next habit, your next meal, your next whatever it is, your next moment, you're just like, okay, that ice cream was delicious. I love that I got to enjoy that with my family. And I trust myself that my next meal is going to be what I meal prepped, or I'm going to focus on vegetables and protein at my next meal, or I'm still going to get up tomorrow morning and work out, and I'm not going to give into that guilt and that shame, because food should not have that power over us, first of all. I always like to say food has nutritional differences in what it does for us, right? An apple is going to digest and metabolize very differently in your body than Oreos, but morally, you're not good or bad for eating something. It just affects your body differently. And so when you enjoy that treat, the mindset shift here is that you're going to let it go and you're going to do the next right thing. That next moment, you're going to do whatever it is that you know helps you feel good, helps you thrive, what you do on a usual basis. And that's where you develop that foundation of nourished, so that when you have those treats now and again, they don't derail you. Your body is really resilient to the ice cream or the cookies one night or the pizza night with your kids. Your body becomes resilient because you're always doing that foundation is always nourished. You're always doing the protein, the veggies, the whole grains, the healthy fats. That's what the foundation of your eating is, so that when you have that indulgence here and there, it truly becomes in moderation. Do you see how that works? It truly does become in moderation, because you're having it and then you're letting it go and you're doing the next right thing. And that is where that food guilt will stop. That is where you'll finally be able to be like, oh, I'm actually consistent. Even though I'm having treats, even though I'm having chips and salsa with my family every Saturday night, even though I'm having ice cream with my kids once a week, I am seeing consistency in my healthy lifestyle because I'm letting it go and I'm doing the next right thing. My child's been waking up every morning at 6 a.m., so it's okay. Daddy's on it. So when you let it go and you do the next right thing, that's where you find your freedom. And that's where you're never on track or off track with Nourished and Free. And this is a very important concept that I teach my clients, is that... Vas, can you get her? Okay, so this is a very important concept that I teach my clients, is that you're never on or off track with Nourished and Free. So that ice cream, you're not off track. You're still living your Nourished and Free lifestyle, because nothing is not allowed in this type of living. That feeling that you're off track is what leads you to guilt, spiral, shame, and then binge eat. So we have to stop that in its tracks. We have to tell ourselves, I'm not off track. I'm still living my nourished and free life with ice cream, with pizza, with chips and salsa. I'm never off track because I'm gonna go right back to doing the next right thing. And that's where you'll find your consistency. And this is where you'll stop the food guilt, you'll stop the shame spiral, you'll stop the binge eating and emotional eating, and you'll learn how to actually be consistent with how you're eating and the nutrition that you're putting in your body. And this is what helps my nourished and free clients find freedom and consistency. This is how they're able to lose weight while still eating their favorite foods. And this is freedom, you guys. This is freedom instead of feeling like you have to be low carb keto Monday to Friday and then you're like binging on bread over the weekend. How about you incorporate that bread during your week? You're not off track doing that because you get to create your own lifestyle and you're finding your own freedom in the process. And this is exactly the work I do with my nourishing free clients. And I'm really, really excited to announce to you guys first that I finally have spots open for one-on-one coaching. So I haven't opened up one-on-one coaching since February because my schedule has been jam-packed. We bought this house where, you know, my schedule changed with work, but I now have 5 spots open for nourished and free coaching. So I'm offering it to you guys first. I'm going to announce it on Instagram and Facebook later today, but it is an application process. So I will drop the link to the application in the comments below. Nourished and free is a very high level one-on-one coaching. It's very intimate. It's a 3-month journey together. A lot of clients renew and keep working together because they just, it's a lifetime. It's a lifetime of habits usually that we're trying to work through. So really like 1 or 2 sessions is not going to cut it. This is a lifetime of habits and it's an investment in your health. The definition of investing is that you expect a greater return later, right? So you expect that reward to come later after you put in this work, this time, and this trust that freedom is available for you too. And you are able to reach your goals in this nourished and free way. So I will drop the application link in the comments below. I'm so, so, so excited to onboard new clients. Remember, my nourished and free coaching is nutrition strategy plus mindset. They work together. You can't just learn about nutrition all day long and then expect to see results. And then you can't just work on your mindset, but still, you know, eat in a way that doesn't bless or serve your body or your goals. So we have to marry the two in order to live nourished and free. And that's what I do with my one-on-one coaching. And so remember this mindset shift, let it go, do the next right thing, listen to the songs today if you want to so you remember it even more, and then work through the worksheet. The worksheet has really powerful questions to ask so that you can really reflect on this concept and see how it applies to your life. And so I'm so, so, so excited that you guys joined for this mindset challenge this week. Comment below with any takeaways that you had, any breakthroughs that you had. And I'm just so proud of you for taking this step because mindset work is not easy. It's not fun, but it's often what's going to change the game for us. Like imagine if you actually put this one into your real life, you allowed yourself to have a bowl of goldfish crackers with your kid, and then your dinner was still, you know, whatever you had planned for dinner, whatever it is. You didn't just like, well, screw it. Let me just order out. Let me binge. Let me eat all the snacks in my house because I ruined it anyway. How about you enjoy something and then you let it go and you do the next right thing? Like imagine if that already was part of your life, how different your life would be. And so anyways, I'm so, so, so excited that you guys joined on this Nourished and Free journey. Stay in this group. If you're new to this group, I go live once a week in here with teachings. We do monthly challenges. It's a really fun place to be and you'll learn a lot. And if you do want to take this a step further and kind of up level this area of your life, I am taking on new clients right now. So the application will be in the comments below. I'm only taking applications till next Wednesday. So you have about a week to apply. And I can't wait to chat with you guys and see if my coaching is a good fit for you. So I hope everyone has a great Thursday. Bye, guys.